Aloha, everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions once again, and welcome to the very first episode of Ask a Painter. I know what you're saying, some of you. You're saying, Christopher, you're just copying other people, and you're absolutely right. I am indeed. Why? Well, let's face it. Many Wargaming has Ask a Wargamer. Most people watch it because it's pretty funny. iJustine has Ask IJ. Pretty funny show, again. Even guys like Shay Carl had Question Sunday for a while on his video daily blog that he was doing. Ray William Johnson will occasionally answer questions from viewers. And so, you know, the old saying, I can't remember exactly what it is, but basically it says, you know, the reason I've come as far as I have is because I've stood on the shoulders of giants. You know, if you see something that works well, you might as well go with it. So that's what we're going to do here. I told you we're going to start answering some questions that we get in comments and PMs and emails through video format, and so that's what we're going to do starting today. Today we've got two different things, one coming from a comment and one coming from an email. I'm sorry, one coming from a comment and one coming from a PM, and here's what they are. The first one, it comes from Brandonhud60, and it says, hey, I'm 13, and I'm going to start collecting them soon to paint and show. I don't want to play it. I want it as a hobby. What do you suggest I get for starting? I have a budget of £100 to start. Then I can add pocket money on every now and then. And then Zulgy says, hello there. I'm actively looking on what paints I should buy to start painting models, and I've watched all of your 12 parts on how to paint Space Marines, the flag carrier dude you painted. And I've wondered, if I could start with 30 different paints, all brands together, which one should I get if I want to base coat, paint, highlight, and such with them right away? If I can only have 30 paints, which ones should I get? Two very good questions, okay? Let's start with Zulgy's question first. That came from a PM that he sent me. And I'll be honest with you, you don't need 30 paints. If you're just getting into the hobby, you don't need that many. I'll be honest with you, even if you've been around for a while, you still don't need 30 paints. I've got probably 300 paints around here. Between the rack you see here, the rack that's behind me, and then the rack that's underneath the table, I've got probably close to 300 different paints. On average, I use no more than 25 paints. Most of the paints that you see back behind me here, I've never even opened. I have no idea what some of them look like. I just bought them because at the time I thought they looked cool, and it's best to be prepared in case you ever happen to find a miniature that needs the color paint that you're lacking, all right? For instance, I have this color here. This is French Mirage Blue. Very, very nice color. Very beautiful blue-gray color. I have never used it. I have no idea what model it might go on, but when I see that model, I'll be very happy that I have French Mirage Blue, all right? So, that way I don't have to order it later on. But you don't really need 30 paints. In fact, to answer Brandonhud60's question, I am going to give you a list of 13 paints that you can get started in the painting world with and basically mix just about every other color you could possibly imagine. Okay, so let's get started with Brandon's question, and at the same time we'll answer Zulgy's when we get to the painting stuff. Alright, for Brandon, you asked about, you're 13 years old, you got £100. For those of you U.S. people, I did the currency conversion. That works out to about $165. And you are absolutely in luck. And the reason you are in luck is because I started this hobby with about $35. So you are far ahead of the game already. So here's what you need, okay? We're going to start simple, and we're going to keep track of the money as we go, all right? First thing you're going to need is you're going to need a hobby knife, all right? I would suggest picking up fairly cheap hobby knife. This one's a good one. It's got breakaway blades on it. This will run you about $5, and that's being very liberal if you want a really fancy one, okay? A real cheap one will run you about $2, okay? So you're going to need a hobby knife. You're going to use this to clean up your miniatures and to cut them off the sprues if they're plastic. Don't worry right now about getting sprue cutters. You can do that later on. A hobby knife works just as well. Just be careful, okay? So we got $5 invested into a hobby knife. The next thing you're going to need is some glue, all right? You're going to want to be able to put your miniatures together, and depending on the kind of miniatures that you've got determines what type of glue you need. If you're using plastic miniatures, you're going to need polystyrene cement. This is polystyrene cement from Testers. If you're going to buy Testers polystyrene cement, make sure to buy the orange tube and not the blue tube. The blue tube is non-toxic, and it doesn't work. Orange is good, okay? If you're assembling metal or resin miniatures, you're going to want to have this. This is cyanoacrylate glue. It's basically a strong form of super glue. Okay? Some people use Zap-A-Gap, which is a type of super glue, but I've found that Zap-A-Gap dries very brittle, and any sort of a slight touch on the miniature will actually break the bond, and you'll have pieces falling off of your miniature. So I would suggest avoiding Zap-A-Gap glue. The third type of glue you're going to need is just a bottle of basic school glue. This is going to be used for basing your miniatures, okay? So just basic white school glue. All three of those glues put together will run you about $5, okay? So right now we're talking about $10 worth of stuff. The next thing you're going to need, let's see here, you're going to need primer, all right? You never want to paint a miniature without primer. I would suggest when you first get started, go with a brush-on primer. This is a Reaper's brush-on primer. It runs about $3 a bottle. This one bottle will cover about 40 or 50 figures. Now, I would suggest not getting a spray-on primer, because a lot of times when you first get started, it's difficult to gauge how much primer you actually want to have on the miniature. I know people who've been in the business for 10 years and still don't know how to use a spray can. Okay? Be safe, be conservative, and get yourself a brush-on primer. It's a lot easier to control when you first get started. Okay? Now, you're going to need a way to get that primer onto your figures as well as the paint. By the way, that primer is about $3, in case I didn't tell you. You are going to need some brushes. Okay? I recommend, generally speaking, the Winsor & Newton Series 7 brushes. If you're going to buy Winsor & Newton brushes, I would suggest picking up three sizes. A 000, a 00, and then either a 0 or a 1. My suggestion would be pick up a 1 instead. Those three brushes together will run you about $35. Now, that being said, I would like to caution you that the Winsor & Newton brushes are very delicate. And so if you're brand new to the hobby, you might not be used to being gentle with your brush. You might be very rough with it. And so what's going to happen is those bristles are going to break down a lot faster than they should. So, that being said, if you don't want to spring for the Winsor & Newton brushes, go to your local hobby shop and buy several cheap brushes. Several $5 to $7 range brushes, preferably those made out of sable. Or you can get squirrel's tail. That's decent, but it's not great. Avoid brushes that are synthetic, either a golden tacklon or white nylon. Those are really horrible brushes. Avoid horsehair and camel tail brushes. Very, very junky brushes. You don't want those. Generally speaking, you're going to want to work with either sable or squirrel. Sable is the best in the business, red sable especially. And that's what the Winsor & Newton Series 7 brushes are. But if you go to your local hobby shop and you pick up three or four brushes for about $5 a piece, you can actually have a little bit of money left over for one of these, which is a Games Workshop or Citadel Large Dry Brush. Now, I would recommend getting one of these because when you first get started painting, you are going to use dry brushing as your main method of highlighting. You're probably not going to want to do a lot of layering when you first get started. Combination of either this brush plus the other kind of semi-decent quality brushes, or getting all three of the Winsor & Newton Series 7 brushes is going to run you, again, about $35 for all of the brushes that you're going to need for a while. Now, so what does that give us as far as a total? We've got a hobby knife, which is 5. We have brushes, which are 35, so that's 40. We have glue, which is 45. We have primer, which is 3, so that brings us to 48. Let's be conservative and round it up to 50. Make it easier on me to do the math. All right, when you finish painting your miniature, you're going to need to have a good base on your model. Remember, a good base on the miniature can really make or break a piece. You don't want to put a model onto the table or in a display case that doesn't have a base. It's kind of like having the real Mona Lisa and duct taping it to your wall. It just really doesn't work. You need a nice, beautiful frame for it, okay? So for basing your miniatures, I would suggest picking up a bag of ballast from Woodland Scenics. A bag of ballast will run you about $5. Additionally to that, you could pick up a box of tub of static grass flock. This is about $7, okay? So conservatively speaking, we're up to about $60 right now, maybe $65. If you didn't want to spend the money on both of those, you could simply go with a tub of, what is this stuff called? Blended turf. All right, this works semi-decently as grass. It looks a lot like AstroTurf when you actually put it on the figure, though, so it doesn't look as realistic, but it can be used to work. Now, as far as paints go, let me see how much time we've got. Okay, I tell you what, let me break right here, and we'll come right back, and I'll tell you exactly what paint you're going to want to have to get started in the miniature world.